chances in favour of that testing capacity will continue to increase as a very important component of our approach going forward. In the next slide, you see how that translates into new cases, so that's test positive cases. And again, you see an increase in recent days, and I think that reflects the DNA testing for a second today. We're able to let more people come forward with testing because testing capacity is ramped up. But the numbers have not increased dramatically, and I think that is due to more testing. It's evidence that greater infection in the community is declining. In the next slide, you will see how that translates into people in hospital with COVID-19. As I've said many times, this is a mild disease for the vast majority of people, but unfortunately, for some, hospital admission is required. And you can see that the peak of hospital admissions that I've had, particularly in London, where we saw the steepest rise and we have felt the steepest fall. And since the middle of April, we have begun to see a decline in the overall number of people in the hospital. And that again is evidence that the transmission rate of the virus in the community is falling, and that is translating to fewer people being able to die in the hospital. And then on the next slide, that shows again how this translates into the usage of critical care beds. So these are our sickest patients. Again, a small minority, but nevertheless a very important group of people who have to receive care in intensive therapy units. And you can see once again, as a proportion, this has been declining since the middle of April. And indeed, if we look at the absolute numbers, you can see a decline in absolute numbers too. So again, evidence that we are seeing the benefits of applying the social distancing measures and the reduction in transmission of the virus from the party beginning to have an effect on fewer people with critical care. And then finally, the last two slides unfortunately represent those who have died. Of course, the stories behind every single death and our heart goes out to those loved ones.
Like my stomach's hollow. And there's a big cave. I'm going to be too sad going to bed. It's just, I can't believe how much today's just not been working.
It's Sunday. It's not to let me do things on a Sunday. You suggested it.
I did.
You should have just...
I did that Sunday, it was great. Do you remember I was like fine with it?
Tuesday, Thursday this week, that was like eating at 6.
No, I'm talking about going out. Somebody's going to be the baby. He just throws everything. All this old technology.
Thank you. Tell me
contact tracing app to trial the other point. This week, given you need 50-60% of the high population to download the tap once it's up and running, how crucial, how central would it be for the government's policy of suppressing the virus, and how would it dictate measures put in place or not in terms of the lockdown? And secondly, on casting a similar number, 4 to 76,000 or so. Now, how do you account for that sharp fall in just 24 hours? And how concerned are you by the fall of almost 30,000 tests?
Well, thank you, Dan. On the first, you answered right. When it comes to contact tracing, the more people who download the app that's been developed by the NHS, the better there are some 80,000 passes on there are the ones, and obviously we'd like to see more than half passes sign up to the app. But it's striking, and refers back obviously to Dr. Mason, how the experience of people being throughout the crisis and knowing that there's a contribution of all of us today to helping to keep our neighbours and our communities safe, I think, is a very, very powerful incentive. And the leader of the Isle of Wight Council, the Isle of Wight Senior, and Paul Seeley, have both said that they believe that it's in the interest of the island and of the country that as many people as possible have signed up to the app. It is the case that you might expect that you'll be tempted to be able to test it with fewer people going to work. This might have a difference in the amount of tests that aren't allowed at that time. But again, I don't think in any way to track the major achievement of the NHS and of others, and so significantly increasing the amount of tests that are available.
Yes, so on the app, I think you're absolutely right. If you want components of that, likely that on its own it's going to be the single measure or the single intervention that will ensure that the virus is always under control. There will need to be contact tracing in the way we've always done contact tracing, so people following leads as to who you've contacted. That's exactly why I think Health England are recruiting many thousands of people to help in contact tracing. And it will need to set aside other measures that we've become used to, such as if you are symptomatic, then if you have the virus, if you test positive, you will need to stay at home. So it is one component. The more people that download it and use it, the likely the bigger contribution it will make, but it will not be a single contribution. And of course, testing it will help us to understand before it is deployed exactly what that contribution is likely to be. So testing in the Isle of Wight is a very important phase in understanding how the app is going to be used and what contribution will be.
Thanks, Dan. Do you want to come back on anything there?
Only on the app. Whatever you have maybe from the companies and the research done so far suggests this could actually work because great. It's very new. So I take a couple of sense from President Harris that you're not only reliant on this.
Well, again, Professor Hurst underlined the point that it is, it's one arrow in the quiver, but it is the case that other countries, Germany and France, are developing apps as well, and we want to make sure that they're interoperable. The fact that other developed nations are doing that, this really underlines how wide NSX wants to invest in it.
Developing or using apps, not everybody is deploying one, so you're absolutely right, there will be international learning as we go forward as to when these apps are deployed. In some of the Far Eastern countries, they have been used successfully, so there is evidence that they can be used as part of a series of measures. But I think even in those countries, such as Singapore and other countries, again, it's a suite of measures, it is not a single measure. So we will learn some of that as we test and as we roll it out. And I think the other important point to make is that this will never be about a single set of measures that you freeze and then don't change over time. I think measures will always need to be reviewed and adjusted based on what the infection is doing and what the reality of the situation is. But the app will be an important component of that going forward.
Thank you. Well, turn that to Andrew Gilmore.
Mr. Gove, do you agree with your Transport Secretary that had mass testing been in place sooner, many lives could have been saved? And Mr. Gove, keep going if you're on time.
up?
Well, thank you, Inga. On the first one about the testing,
I think you need to do it with a new one. I think I've got some there. But I might check upstairs. I think either on the first little landing going upstairs, there might be some on the floor in the green box. So like when you go from where our room was up to the top room, on that middle landing, I think there's some filters there. New ones, and you can just replace it. Yeah. Just go and look first and then see if not. You can take it out, but it's not very nice. Otherwise, you just put a new one in. I think they're either there or they'll be in the other room upstairs on the shelf or something. I think they're on that second. Or some kind of box. Okay.
Yeah, I remember it.
There we go. Okay, try that out. I've got these. I've got some videos, so I'm trying to take all these old videos and put them on the computer. So I'm trying to work it out at the moment. The technology part of it. But if I do, I'll let you know the site you can look at.
Be all.
All right. See you later.
Bye bye. I'm going to hold for now, but I think I may have ordered my dinner. Yeah. Oh, if I have, I'll have white.
Okay. Yeah.
Is there enough in the room?
There's two glasses.
Oh, there are? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
four very important questions, because on the first one, about when can we return to normal, I think people have used the phrase a new normal. What they've sought to imply is that we can begin, we hope, as you quite rightly point out, as the onset comes down, to ease some of the restrictions, but we have to do so in a cautious fashion. And the transport sector is right to say that we can begin to see perhaps more reduced form of transport, but provided they are helped to stagger or to. Quite likely asking us why think broadly we saw that flattering of a variety of measures for land and water.
Thanks very much, Matthew. I will turn that to Deanna Roth. Oh, sorry, Chris, you want to come back, forgive me.
I asked Uncle the art value off today.
Sorry. So, Stanley Valance has said that the medical officer that they believe the R value is 0.7. We are measuring that directly at the moment through the work of the Office of National Statistics. I think that's being measured by randomly testing people in the community. Once that data is has been presented to us, once that data is available, I think it will be better to give a more precise figure. But I think, as Patrick also explained, I think it's really impossible to come with an absolute single precise number. Because throughout the country in different settings, it will be slightly different. So I think you will always see a range, but with better data, that range will have.
Thank you very much. Thanks, Chris. I will turn now to Sienna Rogers from Legalist.
Doing a course of this, we'll be looking in the Ministry of Implementation, which I'm chair, at And the reason that
as you mentioned, adding miles of traffic on the set of the structural factors which may lead to inequality and inequality may have been as a result of discrimination. We need to look at all these things proportionately.
Are we
seeing a bit more of that and thinking that this is the right way to do it? very large parts of the country of County 1, but if it is necessary, other parts will have problems, then they can be dealt with in some other way. Whereas it is affected in everybody in the country for this, has now been in lockdown for quite a long time. Yes, because we're now going to be waiting for this grand plan from the Prime Minister Boris Johnson. I think that's what it will take, obviously, because they're coming to this deadline on May 7th, which is when they have to review the lockdown measures once again. It has been every 3 weeks or so. So we're waiting for this real crunch announcement from the Prime Minister about how things could gradually
coronavirus tests have been carried out in the UK on Saturday, and that's below Thank you. It will take 3 years to get schools back open for local decisions to do so. Uses a phone's Bluetooth connection to run. One should install sure be out. Every time you come into contact with someone else that has been out, your phone is going to report that fact. Then if you tell me you have symptoms of coronavirus, that will alert the phones of those other people. They will then need to self-isolate. So what do those on the other white thing?
The more people that get involved, the better. The only problem is that probably a lot of people don't have a smartphone. That could be a problem, I fear.
I think it's a good idea. I think it would be a good thing to try it.
I feel that the island is essentially being used as a testing ground and don't like the thought of being used as guinea pigs.
The app should help automate the whole process, finding out who has the virus. Getting it to enough people won't be easy. For the app to work properly, it needs something like 50 or 60% of the population to take part in it. Here we are, that's about 70 or 80,000 people. Anything less than that, the experiment won't be valid, the virus won't be traceable. The government says if the app works on the island, it will be a national rollout.
We will be asking the whole country, the levels of to download this mobile program, which will help automatically to remove the need for people, individuals to be involved.
The government will now recruit 18,000 people to help with tracking individuals once the app is in place. We are now moving to the next phase of this national effort to control COVID-19. That seems to be the BBC News on the island.
Oh God, well, if Dominic Hughes joins us now from Salford. And Dominic, what struck you most about the state this afternoon?
Marita, ministers are clearly, slowly but surely, moving towards unveiling the next step in this whole process. How do we get out of lockdown without risking a second spike in infections and deaths? Now, they want to meet a number of conditions to do that. They want NHS capacity to be there. They want issues around PPE. To be there. They also want to see a consistent fall in the number of deaths, but also a consistent fall in the number of people being treated in hospital and new infections. And so we have a graph which shows what's happened over the last small period. And this is interesting because it shows that the number of people being treated in UK hospitals has fallen by over 2,000 in the last week alone to around 14,000. Now that is a significant decline of 13% in just a week, and most notably in London, where numbers are half since the peak in mid-April. Now that peak is clearly half, so numbers are now in decline, and it's evident to be here from the government scientists that the transmission rate, this R number that we've heard about previously in the voting, is now on the decline, and that is one step towards lifting the lockdown.
Union and several leading firms across the UK have received draft guidance from ministers today about safer working practices once lockdown measures are eased. The government has given them until 10 o'clock tonight to respond to a proposal. This is correspondent Katie Austin joins me now. It's really important for businesses to know what the world of work should be like whenever the economy does start to reopen. And as the government has been developing guidelines on that, trade unions, business groups and family firms have fed into those discussions. And today they're given the draft guidelines to have a look at and respond to. Businesses want to know practical things, for example, how can you best introduce social distance into an office or a pub or a factory, and so that they can plan and also to reassure their staff and perhaps customers that the way they reopen is a safe way to do things. Well, after these guidelines have had to respond to the business groups, we do expect the government to start outlining how it will look towards raising the economy, perhaps over the next week or so. And one of the thoughts about moving towards the future, so far, the emergency support schemes such as the furlough scheme have gone a long way to limit the economic damage we've seen so far. There's a further call today from the British Chamber of Commerce for such support to be extended if necessary, even if that means sustaining very high levels of public spending. It's emerged that more than 2,000 coronavirus patients in intensive care in England, Wales and Northern Ireland have been treated for kidney failure as well as respiratory problems. Those affected received specialist renal support treatment. That led to a shortage in central
Some people with situation stretching into the night. Even the Queen managed to slip away with her sister Margaret to join the party. Robert Ball, BBC News.
Now, three of the world's top male pole vaulters left of the chance to compete against each other today from their own plans on. The event, described as the ultimate clash, will stream live on the governing body called video link.
Excellent.
No, I don't. I'm relaxing. And make sure you bring us in. No, no, I'm relaxing now, man.
Yeah, so it just shows how destructive a little thing like weighing yourself can be.
Yeah,
yeah,
that's
right.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
She was just average. It was just on, it was nearer though. Lower waves. But, you know, it seemed to really distress her. She kept talking about it. It wasn't good. Babe,
yeah.
What are you doing, hon?
I'm getting down. Come on, sir. I'm not going to go.
Gary wants his landlord, the pub chair, Green and King, to
Cool.